Hello everyone, welcome to Edutab. So in today's session, we are going to discuss about the money market and the capital market instruments. We have already discussed about the money market and the capital market in our previous session. And this topic about the money market and the capital market instruments is very important because many previous year questions has been asked directly from this question. Okay, and I will show you that which previous year questions. So before starting with the session, please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are new to the channel. And please join our Telegram channel for the PDF of this session. And you can get the link of the Telegram channel in the description box below. So now here, the first question is in the RBI Grade B 2019. Treasury bills is a financial instrument which is a... This you can surely answer by the end of the session as is... It is a very direct question that has been asked in the RBI Grade B of 2019. The second question is, commercial papers are issued for what purpose? This also we will discuss in today's session. And then again in the previous year question of the RBI Grade B 2019, the question about the which of the following is a characteristic of bond and the not a characteristic of equity. This question was asked. Okay, so starting with the money market instrument, see, the first instrument that we will discuss today is the treasury bills. Okay, treasury bills are the bills that are issued by the government, or that are the government treasury bills, we can say. And the RBI is the one that auctions these treasury bills. And these treasury bills have zero risk. They are the zero risk instruments. As they are backed by the government, so of course they do not have any risk involved. But if the risk are less, if the risk is zero, the return is also not very much. So the treasury bills, these are the zero risk instruments, but the returns are also very less. The maturity periods are like 91 days. Okay, that is like 3 month instrument it is, 182 days or 364 days. Okay. Then issued at a lesser price than their face value. So it is like the interest is not involved, just that if the treasury bill is of 100 rupees, it will be issued at, it will be given to you at 95 rupees, and at maturity you will get 100. So instead of taking or giving any interest payment, the government just in the start only just take 95 rupees or less value than the face value. Okay, and when the treasury bill matures, then it gives the proper face value. So it is issued at a lesser price, it is given at a lesser price, and at the maturity, the face value is given to you. So that is the income, that is the extra return that you are getting. So now cash management bills. See, the thing was that the treasury bills had the maximum, like it was like maximum, the maturity period was of 364 days and the minimum maturity period was of 91 days. But there was a need that lesser than that we should also have. So the cash management bills are like the treasury bills that are issued by the government, but they have the maturity period of less than 91 days. Okay. Next is about the commercial papers. See, commercial means they are issued by the corporates, by the companies or the financial institutions or the primary dealers. They are the ones that are issuing these. So it is not very secure. So compared to the treasury bill, we can say that they are unsecure. Short-term promissory note. See, promissory note is what? The name itself suggests that the company is promising the creditor. The person that has taken the money, the borrower is promising the person that is giving the money that we will return. The company will return the money to you. Okay. So it is a promissory note by the person by the company that has taken the loan. Okay. So compared to the treasury bills, they are more unsecured. They are short-term promissory note. The company is promising to return the money. It is from 7 days, minimum is 7 days to up to 1 year. Okay. It can extend up to 1 year. Then promise higher returns. It is unsecured, it has risk involved. It is not zero risk. So it has some risk involved. So of course it will promise the higher returns, otherwise why will anyone take the risky thing when the returns are not very high? Okay, we will take the risky asset only when the returns are also high. So commercial papers are issued by the companies or the financial institutions, some of the financial institutions, or we can say primary dealers. So they want to raise the money, they want to get the money. So they are promising that please give us the loan and we will return the loan back in 7 days or up to 1 year it can go. So it will be written in the promissory note. Next is the certificate of deposits. See, the companies can raise money through the company paper, but commercial paper, but if the banks, if the commercial banks want to raise the money, then how will they be able to raise the money? They can raise the money through the certificate of deposits. And there are some very few financial institutions also that are permitted to raise the money through the certificate of deposits. So this is a money source for the banking system, as well as commercial banks in India, and selected very few financial institutions are allowed to issue the certificate of deposit to raise the money. Minimum size of it is 1 lakh and it is issued in the multiples of 1 lakh only. For banks, 7 days to 1 year. Again, it is similar like the commercial paper, but commercial paper are issued by the companies and this is issued by the banks or a very select few financial institutions. Commercial paper are, the minimum size of the commercial paper should be 5 lakh and in the multiples of 5 lakh it is issued. Here the minimum size is 1 lakh and in multiples of 1 lakh it is issued. Okay, so this is the instrument through which the banks are raising the money. The banks are raising the cash, okay? And anyone can invest it in. The retail investors and the NRIs even, or the institutional investors even NRIs can invest in it, but they cannot repatriate their investment. So next is call money. See, call money is issued by the banks. Again, this is for the banks. Banks can raise the money through this if they are in a liquidity crunch situation, if they want to complete their SLR or the CRR terms that is defined by the RBI, that you have to keep this much liquid assets with you. So if they want to raise the money overnight, if they want to raise the money overnight for one day only they want, then they can have the call money. Okay, here the minimum is 7 days and the maximum is 1 year. But here the minimum is 1 day. Okay, call money. The scheduled commercial banks excluding the RRBs, the cooperative banks other than the land development banks and the primary dealers are permitted to participate in call or notice money market both as borrowers and the lenders. So they can participate both as borrowers. The banks are the one that can participate as the borrower also and as the lender also. So one bank is giving the money to the other bank. The one bank that has excess liquidity with itself will give the loan to the other bank that needs the liquidity, that needs the cash. Because the other bank, okay, so the first bank that has excess liquidity will also earn some interest, some payment on that. So next is, it is overnight. That is for one day. Call money is for one day. Then next is, notice money is for 2 to 14 days. It is same as call money, but it is for 2 to 14 days. Then comes the term money, that is 15 days or more. Okay, so I hope you have understood all the instruments of the money market. These are the main instruments that are circulated in the money market. Okay, next is capital market instruments. There are two main types of instruments that are circulated in the capital market, the debt instruments and the equity instruments. Just think for a second that if a company wants to raise the money for long term, it wants to establish some company, it wants to establish some assets, what will it do? It can either borrow the loans, or what can it do? It can give its ownership, its percentage of ownership to some other person. So it can raise loans and that will be like 100 rupees it has raised as a loan. So it will be a liability for the company to give this 100 rupees back. Okay, to give this 100 rupees back to the person from which it has, from the investor from which it has taken the money. So this 100 rupees plus some interest rate also it will have to give. So this is the debt instruments, that bonds we can say usually. So some interest rate or some higher face value, or the face like the bond will be issued at a lesser value than the face value. So this is how the loans work. This is how the company can take the loans by, and it is the liability of the company that it has to pay back the money. So it is a fixed income for the investor. Fixed income for the investor. It will get its money back as well as it will get some interest payment on that money. Then comes the equity instruments. See, in the equity instruments, instead of taking the liability, instead of taking the borrowing the money, the company is thinking, okay, I will sell some part of my company. The ownership, a percentage of the ownership of my company I will sell, so that I will not have the liability to give back any money. And I will not even have the liability to give any interest payment, extra interest payment. So on this, why will the investor will buy the shares? It is getting the percentage of ownership, means it is getting some of the percentage of the dividend That is, it will also get some percentage of the profits of the company. So the company is not liable to give the, like if the investor has invested 100 rupees, the company is not liable to give this 100 rupees back to the investor. It will just give a percentage of the profit of as per the ownership rights. Okay. So this is the capital market instruments, and there are derivatives also that are mostly circulated in the secondary market of the capital market. This derivatives, I will make a separate video because it is a very lengthy and very interesting, as well as questions has been asked directly on the derivatives. So it becomes very important to understand the derivatives. So we will, derivatives just that there is some underlying asset, and derivative is a contract based on that underlying asset. Okay, this we will discuss in a separate topic later on. So these questions are the homework questions for you all. I hope you know the treasury bills now, you know the commercial papers now, and what is the bond and the equity and the difference between the both. Okay. So Katie, Mithil, Raj Lakshmi, Yash, Jamin, Yogita, Timothy, as well as Hansa. These were the people who have given the right answer for the session of the question of the previous session. So well done you people, and thank you very much. If you have any query, you can mail us here, or you can contact us through this number. Thank you.